By 2050, researchers have estimated that there will be more plastic in the oceans than fish by weight. 32% of all plastic packaging ends up in nature every year. In 2025, waste generation will increase by 70% compared to 2010. Linear economy is the way that we currently extract, make, use and dispose of products, and means that we are not using our resources in a responsible way. My name is Christine Berg and I'm a circular economy advisor for TOMRA. Every year, between $80 and $120 billion worth of material are lost. If you think about plastic production as an example, because it's not collected and recycled in a meaningful way. And so much of the material has high value, high quality, and can easily have a second, third, and fourth life. But currently, we are simply treating it as waste. And at TOMRA, we know that waste is an old-fashioned concept, and it's actually resources for something new.
My name is Volker Rehrmann. I'm Executive Vice President of TOMRA, and I'm heading up our recycling and mining business and the newly established division of circular economy. TOMRA was actually founded by two brothers in 1972, who developed and invented the world's first automatic reverse vending machine. Another milestone for TOMRA was the development of the world's first automatic waste sorting system. Since then, we have pioneered many, many cutting-edge technology solutions that we use in two business areas, collection solutions and sorting solutions. Mother Earth can only generate as much as it can, and we are consuming much more. Sooner or later, our resources will be gone. But I can tell you it will happen if we don't change to a circular economy where we will reuse our limited resources.
A circular economy can be quite a complex concept to understand, but one simple way that I like to explain it is in the analogy of a tree. Because a tree uses nutrients from the soil, sunlight, and CO2 to produce oxygen through its leaves. But eventually in the fall, the leaves fall to the ground, they're absorbed back into the soil, and they in turn become nutrients for that tree or the tree next to it. So nothing is waste, everything is a resource for something new. So a reverse vending machine is basically a machine that takes back bottles, cans, in a deposit return scheme. By keeping it in a closed loop, when you go to a machine, you return your bottle or your can, and you get your deposit back, when you do that, you help contribute to a more circular economy. It's just one part of a more sustainable value chain for how we can have closed loop recycling for bottles and cans to make sure that, as is so important for a circular economy, you maintain the quality and the value of the material when you recycle. It's a beautiful example of the circular economy, because it literally teaches people the value of waste in a very concrete way.
That's where it all starts. So I would say that's one of the biggest challenges, that people realize and understand that we cannot continue like that. Once this is there, we design our products different. We need to design them for a circular world. We need to design them to be reused whenever possible. We need to design them when we dispose them, that they can easily be recycled. This transition or change towards a circular economy and towards more sustainable businesses does not only come from companies who have realized and seen that. This push is coming a lot from the consumers. And they are pushing their brands to become more sustainable. They have an expectation from the companies they buy from. We have social networks, which gives consumers much more insight, knowledge and power. And they have this fine feeling for what's going to happen. And they are really pushing for a change in this world.
Because we're all interconnected and our goods and our food essentially travel more than we do. So we're always part of a global, quite complex value chain. And then to take that position in the value chain where you look both ways and you realize your role and what impacts, negative and positive, you can trigger both ways, is very important, because there's no production today that exists in a vacuum. So companies that position themselves as thought leaders and take on the role of building this new way of doing business they're going to be increasingly important in the transition to a circular economy. Because we know that there are between 8 to 12 million tons of plastic waste that ends up in the ocean every single year. And about 80% of that comes from land-based sources. So when I get to work with innovative infrastructure and designing systems on land that turn off the tap of litters, protecting that is one of the most rewarding things that I get to do every single day.
This world has finite resources, and everything we do at TOMRA is about protecting those resources and helping the world recycle. And last but not least, I can tell you, I have sons, and you know the younger generation is so passionate about climate change. We old people very often don't care so much. And my boys, they are not necessarily proud of me because I'm a successful businessman. They are proud because what I do is doing good for the environment. And what more can you have than to see that your kids are proud of what you're doing and what you have achieved?